Conventional plastic recycling is usually something only big companies can do, because it requires massive, expensive machines. These machines are heavy, stationary, and need a whole team to operate them. The process is really centralized, which means plastic waste has to travel long distances before it gets recycled. The cost and size of these machines make it impossible to set up recycling in places without a big budget or where transporting waste isn't feasible. Right now, there is no small-scale automatic recycling solution that can handle effective decentralized recycling. So why not change that?
My name is Manuel and I am the developer of TARS.
TARS stands for Dynamo Automatic Recycling System and is essentially a desktop machine that creates useful new products from plastic waste. The machine is low cost, runs automatically and recycles waste without the need for human intervention. TARS is small, easy to operate and fits on a desktop. It can be powered with a simple wall plug and operated from almost anywhere in the world. Using the principle of injection molding, TARS repeatedly produces high quality products with great mechanical properties. At the beginning of the process, shredded plastic waste is loaded into the flake tank. The flakes are dispensed into the extruder, where the plastic is heated and melts. It is then injected into a mold cooler nozzle. The mold shapes the material and cools it down. Once the part has cooled, the finished product is injected and the process starts over again. This way, hundreds of precious new parts can be produced in less than an hour. The products that can be made with this machine range from various types of wall mounts and housings for electronics or phone covers to kitchen items like this egg cup. This machine is in development since 2018, and I had the idea after an internship in a big recycling company. I was a bit disappointed that there was no such recycling machine on a small scale, so I started to work on my own prototype. The first one was really rudimentary and followed by many other prototypes. The latest version of this machine was even modeled entirely from 3D printed parts before I manufactured it. This helped me to get a sense of how the machine would look and function, and additionally, I discovered many flaws in my design during the assembly and manufacturing process. In the future, I plan to create several prototypes for testing in various institutions and places. These trials will provide feedback and help refine the machine's design and functionality. Right now, there is only one of these machines in existence, but eventually there could be hundreds of these machines distributed around the world to recycle material locally and on the spot. If you're interested in the project or want to follow the journey, feel free to visit my Instagram where I document the development, or visit my Ko-fi if you consider supporting the project. Thank you for watching.